should have somehow realized what you got to do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. Back here, the word is on the street that the fire in your heart is out. I'm sure you've heard it all before, but you never really had a doubt. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads we have to walk are winding, and all the lights that lead us there are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know how. Maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. Today was gonna be the day, but they'll never throw it back to you. By now you should have somehow what you're not to do. I don't believe that anybody feels the way I do about you now. And all the roads that led you there were winding, and all the lights that light the way are blinding. There are many things that I would like to say to you, but I don't know. Said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. And after all, you're my Wonderwall. I said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me.
Friends, that is Wonderwall by Oasis from 1995, and it is a strumming and a chord change marathon, so it's not for the faint of heart, but it's really a fun song to sing and play. Let's talk about the chords first. So there are five chords in Wonderwall. The first chord, well, let's say this before we even get into the chords. You are going to maintain your ring finger on the second string third fret and your pinky on the first string third fret above the capo. And by the way, we're capoed with a full capo on the second fret. But you're going to maintain those there throughout the song. So really, the song is about changing chords, the left-hand portion of the song, or the fretting hand, sorry for those of you that fret with your right hand, is all about moving your index and your middle fingers around. So it's kind of a very interesting way to interpret a song. So let's talk about the first chord. So needless to say, you've got ring on 2nd string 3rd fret, pinky on 1st string 3rd fret, and you're playing an E minor. So I'm using my index finger on the 5th string 2nd fret, middle finger on the 4th string 2nd fret. Okay, so that's the first chord. Then we go to a G. So I'm not going to repeat the ring and pinky finger each time, but now we're moving to a G shape. So I've got my my middle finger on the 6th string 3rd fret, index finger on the 5th string 2nd fret, okay? G shape. Country G, bluegrass G, whatever you want to call it. So E minor, 7th, G. Then we go to a D sus 4. So really all we're doing is adding the index finger to the 3rd string 2nd fret, and we're playing 4 strings on that one. And then we have an A7 sus 4. Okay, so now I'm moving the index to string 4 fret 2 above the capo and middle to string 3 fret 2 above the capo. Okay, is that everything? No, we have the C add 9. So now what I'm doing from my A7 sus 4 is I'm just moving my middle finger to string 5 fret 3 above the capo, leaving that index on string 4 fret 2. Okay, so those are the chords in the song. So there's kind of a drone going on these strings 1 and 2. E minor 7 to a G, D sus 4. A7 sus 4, E minor 7 to a G, D sus 4, A7 sus 4, E minor 7 to a G, D sus 4, A7 sus 4. Okay, so let's talk about the strum pattern. So in its most basic form, you can do all down. Down, down. This is the way to play it, just to get the feel. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what I'm doing is down, up, down, 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 up, down, up, down, 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 up, down, up, down, 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 up. So I need to tell you, really not that much. It's to put the whole thing together and play it accurately will take, as it took me, probably 20 times playing it, to play it, you know, 98% mistake free. But the cool thing is, capoed on the 2nd fret, this version pretty much follows the YouTube video that has about 450 million views, so if you want to really test out your chops, try to play along with Wonderwall by Oasis on YouTube. So let's close out with, let's see, how about the last I Said Maybes? I said maybe you're gonna be the one that saves me. Outro. on the G, we do a down, up, down, and then shift to that E minor seventh with an up. One, two, three, four. So there you have it, Wonderwall. A chord change and strumming marathon, but a real good test of your rhythm. And if you want to try and sing it, that's a challenge as well. There's, I know for me, it's pretty much hits the top of my range. But anyway, if that's the case with you, or if you can't reach those high notes, just pop the capo off and play it without a capo. Same shapes. So anyway, hope you guys enjoyed Wonderwall by Oasis in standard tuning, capoed on the second fret with all these droning notes going on the treble strings. Hope you enjoy singing and playing this. I look forward to sending you another song very soon. Until then, adios, my friends.